Hello everyone, this is Slagface, welcome back to Spellcross, and let's get to the last mission of the second level of the second season of this show. And we are ready, our units are all at maximum, we have all the experience we need. We've exploited all the resources. We haven't done that much research, but that can wait. All our units are ready. And we can just jump into it. The fog has dissolved and crowds of orcs and muggletary have emerged. We must locate their commander and kill him. The refugees claim the commander is an orc captain named Dator. Alright. So immediately we can see that right before our starting position is some slope. So it might be a good idea to get on it before we dig in and fend off the first attackers. Let's take a look first. Okay, so there's a road going north, but this is not a sole hill, it's sort of like a ridge, and can go through here. That means that I will have to do the forest. We'll probably go all the way around. There is a ballista there, waiting for me. Okay, good shot, but surprisingly enough, no one's killed. So let's see if the ballista is going to follow me. I see some movement. Can I reach him? Not yet. I think there is some movement. Let's see if they're going to attack me with more than one ballista. Okay, he still haven't killed any hummers. That's fortunate. And I can open fire on him. I'm well dug in and he gets probably killed in opponent fire. Okay, there's our first catch of the day. I think I remember that I will have to go up and down again and up again. It's sort of like a maze. If I had infantry, I could go through the forest, but then I would get killed immediately. Okay, there is an arrow thrower. I hope he's out of range. Luckily, he gets a little bit of opponent fire. But yeah, he attacked the heavy units. I also need to work on some experience for the first for the new mortar APC. So I will hope to just damage this guy down, and so that he can kill him. Exactly, it was half the first level. Let's see what they're planning. Scouts, can I get somewhere? I'll just cut through all this footage so you can see the map revealed, but as you can see, it's a two layers of forest, so this is needing nowhere. And as I tried to move further, I found out that they're actually planning to attack me. So let's hope that the hummer is not getting cut off. Yes, let's give him another kill and the first level. That is good. Okay. Great position to fight. But I don't mind it. I'm feeling quite strong and confident that I can encounter those guys while moving. Yeah, it's not that many of orcs, so I should be able to take care of them. Yeah, as you can see, it's very easy for the flamethrower unit to just wipe those orcs off. So as long as I'm not attacked by, can you shoot? Yeah. Oh, I shouldn't have missed. As long as I'm not attacked by some heavy units that could kill off a lot of infantry, I don't fear those small encounters. It's easy experience, and at least something is happening along the way. And yeah, you can see that you're progressively feeling much more confident. Receiving. The good thing is that, okay, I was hoping to give the mortar unit the shot, but yeah, they're just too strong. So far it was surprisingly easy. There's some more orcs coming through the forest. Let's peek around the corner. Yeah, there's nothing. Let's see if you can. Okay. Can you hit them? Yes. Good. Some arrow throwers. They might want to get a shot at me. Yeah. Captain Haverill got damaged a bit, but that's okay. No real harm done. Move into attack position and get some shots at him. So far I've met just some scout units. It's really nothing for a final battle. This is just to maybe it will make me feel overconfident. Yes, but I want the mortar unit to get the kill if possible. Yes. Let's just consolidate the units a little bit. And hide the scout. Maybe, yes, we can get some opponent fire against the flyers. Maybe to get rid of them eventually. Yes, that's the first one. This might work, this might be enough, but probably not. They don't have too much attack against the aerial units. Doesn't seem to be provoking any land units attacking me, but still blinding them is very important for me, because that really reduces the danger of the siege units. However, I'm also exposing them. So I will move a little more cautiously. And it's quite dangerous because they tend to one-shot the hammer when they see it. Oh. Now I have provoked them. Waiting. Yeah, lost one piranha from Captain Berger. Yeah, there are. A lot of elves. Okay. Not the best position for me right now. We'll have to do. Luckily it's easy for me to dispose of the elves, but they are very dangerous. Can I shoot at someone? Yes, at least you. Great. The key is not to let them shoot. This is not a good position. I'm out of range, they're in range. So I need to move in. Still need to. Oh, there is more of them. Can you shoot? Good. Great. Still very much useful. This might give them confidence to attack me. Alright, so with another unit, that is a new level. That's good. That's very important. You guys move in. You try to finish them off. Yeah, I was hoping for you to finish off two units and get some more experience, but that's alright. This will have to do. Yeah, you guys hide for now. The elves don't have too much armor, but there's a lot of them and they do damage me when they hit, and while I'm on the move I don't have that much cover. I need you to attack this guy. I'll probably lost some piranhas, yes. Two. Good, at least you got third level. This fight is not gonna be for free. But I've counted with that. You move a bit. Now I would like the AMX to hopefully finish them off. No, doesn't matter. You get the kill. There will be more. Yeah, these guys are damaged. However, they still managed to almost destroy my hammer. But overall, it's just two of them killed. Yes. This should give this APC another kill. And they're getting close to each other with the experience. So we have survived this ambush with the loss of three piranhas. It's gonna be expensive, but that's alright. Should be more cautious and not waste the saves all that much. And those sneaky bastards are waiting for me, but I can see them now, so no surprise attacks for you. Let's move in. I will have quite enough shots with the piranhas combined with the mortars to kill it off, I hope, or at least to damage it so much that they are not going to pose a threat to me, but I believe that it should be enough to kill them. Good. Let's form here. Okay, so I've repositioned my units here, and now I can actually get a shot at them, even though they have the cover. It should draw them out, and they should get caught in the crossfire, exactly like this. And since they're elves, I should kill a lot of them before they can reach me and get a shot at my unprotected units. That's two of them and some orcs. Don't really care about those guys. Alright. Nicely hidden flamethrower with a good position to just burn those guys to ashes. Let's get you. Oh, let's get you a little bit more experience. You're also, Captain Haverill is also almost at a new level. Almost everyone could be able to get a new level. But I'm going to give the kill to the AMX. And that seems like that was it from this ambush. I've already found them, but they keep killing my they keep killing my scout, and they don't really want to come out of hiding. I wonder why. They have a very nice position there. Sitting on the hill, a lot of elves with a ballista, and they really don't want to come down so I can shoot them to death. I wonder why. It also almost seems like I would have to attack them aggressively. Maybe if I shot at the palisade, you might recognize it. Yes! So, it was a good call. However, I am in a big danger. They will get a lot of shots at me. Are we going? Some damage, some losses. But that's okay. Yes. Can you guys shoot at them? No, I need to get in range, but that's okay. I knew it will have to come down to this. I still retain two attacks. I would like to use the flamethrowers if possible, yes, because they can just decimate the elves in almost one shot. The commandos can't attack, but you guys can. So I'll let you. Okay, you've got another level. Good. So I'll let you kill them off. And I will sacrifice this, those two attacks to move in. Okay, that was. This was stupid, but there's more elves in, actually. Yeah, some of them are still standing there. Three. Quite a lot. You guys move back. I want the heavier units to soak up the shots, I need to get rid of the ballista, but yeah, I don't know. Ballista has attack 18, the elves have attack 17 with the, all the, their levels, so they're almost equally dangerous. Maybe the ballista is more dangerous since it's... you could get the level if you hit. The ballista is probably more dangerous as it has more defense. But I need to kill them off if possible, because those guys will come in for attack, but they expose themselves. I am losing piranhas here and there, but I finally managed to lure them out, and I will just occupy the hill for now. You can shoot at everyone, you can't. Move in for attack. And let's get rid of them. Yes, now you've got the level. That's positive. They're dead. Okay. I'll try to give the kill to the AMX to level him up eventually. You got a new level as well, that's good. I'm losing some units and just losing a lot of money, but at least I'm getting a lot of experience. It's almost more important. And good, the hill ends up here. But it's not the last position at all. I will be forced to move in. This was risky. I'll try to break in to see a bit and maybe lure them out if there is someone behind the palisade. However, it doesn't seem so. I'll try to move through with, well, destroying the palisade, because it is just one tile wide, just to give me a little bit more space, because standing in a convoy in the corridor would be a very bad position to get ambushed. Might have seen me, so I'll wait a bit and see if someone will come greet me. And there they come, just when I got rid of my shots, I get ambushed, of course, but just orcs. It's okay, my infantry is not in danger. Can they shoot? No, but I'll move them in. They can cover the back. Hummer. The Hummer might get some kills as well. But yeah, he can't attack him, but he could attack this guy. No. But you still need the experience if you would manage to kill someone, but you and you need the experience. This is not a dangerous situation, and I'm glad that I haven't yet destroyed all of those fences, because it slows their advance. They can't swarm me now. So I'm in an advantageous position. Not afraid of orcs, I'm afraid of the shooters. How about you? Yes, you got the next level. Attack 13. Okay, some simple orcs. Yes, they're trying to come around. That's not gonna work, guys. Let's give this one to the flamethrower unit. Oh, they haven't killed them. Okay. You get it. Sure enough, they're coming from behind. But it's just one unit of orcs. It's not enough. Well, you've got a new level. And this is what I was hoping for. The elves are coming in, but through that one tile wide spot, which means that they don't see me, and they tend to get opponent fire, and I can kill them off without a real danger. I need to look. Okay. So the boss will be here somewhere here. I'd definitely be on the hill. And I just need to get out of this maze. And I hope I'm not going to run into some heavily defended ridge filled with heavy weapons. This is good, they're trying to find me. This is not good. Okay, I don't know if he lost one or not, but I need to see them. Yeah, just shot him a little bit and finish off with the mortar, because there will be more and I need the spare shots. Yes, there's still more palisades here, but I am quite in the heart of their base. Alright, let's go out a little bit more. There's a piece of road there, but I'm not going there. It's a trap, if I've ever seen one. Here is the hill. And there was the Hummer. So I went back a bit to get my Hummer back. However, the situation is not very easy here, because here is the mountain. There is a very nice shooting pack of three ballistas and arrow throwers, and they insta-kill the Hummer. And I've moved those mortars in position here, so they actually can shoot up, but the problem is that I can't see there, and there is a harpy, and the harpy scouts for them, so they can see me and kill me before I do anything. So what I need to do somehow attract the harpy down. You can see that it gets very quick. The siege units have also, same as me, they have just two ticks of sandbags. So my thoughts here are that I am going to damage the palisade to almost destroy it, and then I will use, I need to take care of not destroying it in one place, otherwise they will be able to shoot at me. Now I will move in. Yeah, there is the harpy. And there is the castle of the Dartor, the leader. So the idea is to knock down this wall now with the commandos and storm them. Drive to them, because when I knock down this wall, they're not going to get opponent fire, and I will be able to shoot at them with my mortars, and drive at them and shoot at them with my piranhas, hopefully killing enough of them to avoid any total losses. It's not important that, for example, Captain Berger has just 8 units now, because this is the last mission, and when I win, all of my units will be replenished, like if I recruited them. So, let's try this. And I'm going to use the last save here. So now I can see them. It's actually just 2 ballistas and 1 arrow thrower. And I can keep the mortar units behind the fence and just knock down these fences. And when I drive here, I will still have some attacks remaining, but I am counting with losses. Okay. This might have been a bad decision. No. No, I'm doing this. This guy has a nice range. I'm going to use him to take out as many enemy sandbags as I can. Okay, so that's the ballista. And yes, you can't shoot here, that's rather strange, but you can. The harpy is a problem, but yeah, you'll see this might not work for the first time.
target, sir.
Waiting. And now I can actually attack them with the mortar to soften them up, because they are going to hit me.
Waiting.
But I hope they won't be as strong now. Okay, I almost lost my AA gun.
Receiving.
Move back. And I need to continue. Going to repair Captain Keltz. Use Captain Berger. To hopefully deal with the
next target, sir.
I'd like to see the last ballista, yes. Those guys can deal with them. But I need to weaken the other ballista, and if I drive out one step, I will retain the two attacks, and I can attack the ballista now. So I will try to damage it a bit. It was not very effective. They might destroy them. Never mind. If I move in like this, he will need to drive here to attack me. Can you shoot at him? Yes. Their leader is somewhere here. Once he comes out, there will be a very, very, very short cutscene. And I want to now, if possible, get rid of this harpy. So far, it's working well. Okay, you even got a new level. Let's move you to position here, and you here, and hope for the best. I want to save those guys, and they would like to kill them off. Oh, this was... and there he is. Yes, so if he dies, okay, I basically lost all my artillery. That ballista just killed them off. I'll start healing those guys. I'd like to see him, and I'd like to get rid of that thing. Alright. This ballista can still ruin my day. I can shoot at you. Yeah, let's go for the kill. That's two attacks. One attack. One attack. Two attacks. Is it going to be enough? I don't know. However, I am willing to try it.
Waiting.
Two attacks, okay.
Receiving.
Come on, guys, I really want to kill him. And that's it. So, I do hope that we get them repaired. But we haven't lost anyone. So that's okay. It should be okay. Success. The enemy commander is dead and the camp lies in ruins. Our troops have torn down the temple and found 2,000 victims buried beneath it. The entire territory is from this moment on in the hands of the Alliance. The front line has moved several tens, in some places even hundreds of kilometers to the north. You have been requested to return to HQ. Okay. Killed quite a lot of units, got some levels, and...
Your results have convinced headquarters to transfer you to a more important part of the front. The forces of darkness are starting to retreat. Their units are being utilized elsewhere. You can appreciate how much this lull has helped us. We can now concentrate our forces and stage a powerful counterattack. Your primary task is to gain control over the central road so that our supply route can be secured. You will have light armored carriers and tanks to help you with your mission. Good luck. Not since the first migration of man from the plains of Africa has humanity experienced anything like the current exodus. Instead of venturing into a brave new world, man has been forced to flee for his very existence, overwhelmed by the progressing tide of magic and evil. Those who managed to escape were either killed by orcs, or worse still, captured. Mass human sacrifice had begun. A small number of refugees were allowed to join the Alliance's armies. In the beginning, they were looked down upon by the CGI commanders, but they were priceless allies. The addition of new troops did not stem the flow of traitors. Mercenaries tried to find employment in the service of our enemy, training them in battlefield strategy and the handling of modern weapons, in return for which they were promised wealth and sanctuary. Among humans, there are always some calculating and cowardly individuals. The Bloc of Free States was established in Middle and East Asia. Its member states offered their wholesale support to the forces of darkness. What they hope to gain from such an act is beyond all comprehension. There was still a silent voice of hope. Hope of victory and liberation. Time was needed to turn the dream into reality. This task was truly a daunting one. Bloody Desert.
And we are in a new level. Congratulations, you've been promoted to the rank Lieutenant Colonel. Colonel Commander Mager was promoted to Mayor. Commander Gerovsky was promoted to Mayor. Headquarters is sending reinforcements. Okay, does that mean... That does mean that I am back at maximum. So, that was useful tactics. Everyone is back at maximum, and we have some nice money, 452, and we are in the desert. The desert is a nasty one. Well, everything is nasty. We've got 218 money areas for 13 rounds. That's nice. We have some new technology to develop, like some electromagnetic weapons that leads to a nice anti-infantry APC that I'm not gonna use. It's cool, but in this game you don't really want specialized units. It's better to have universal units that can damage and kill everything. Even though the flamethrowers proved to be quite effective. Yeah, I don't know yet. Maybe I will get some of them, but the research means so much money that that's probably the reason why I'm not gonna do it. Yeah, we will need the engines, turbine engines too, and diesel engines one, and new gun technology that will be important. And we got some tanks. TAM and STRV, or Stridsvagn, the Swedish tank. So, in the next episode, we will reorganize a little bit, buy some new units, some tanks probably, and let's see how much unit can I have. Maximum number of units per attack 18, and 6 commanders, and we have some quite urgent quest. So yeah, we managed to kill off the enemy commander. He got promoted, we have quite experienced units, and we're in the third level. So in the next episode, it's gonna be a first episode of third season. We're gonna get introduced into some desert fighting and very probably to new enemies, which will be even more dangerous than the ones that we've encountered until now. Thank you guys for watching. Like the video if you liked it. Subscribe to the channel. And I will see you next time in the season 3. See ya!